approximately 12:07 p.m. today, dispatcher received a call from the Wells Fargo Bank on East Renfro, 400 block, on a suspicious person. Again, that suspicious person call is something that we received, that customer was coming in, coming out, doing various things that just seemed a little bit odd. Dispatch took the information and dispatched it to our patrol officers. We had some detectives in plain clothes as well that happened to be in the area and advised that they were willing to assist, and they'd also be in the area to look in and see if there was anything else going on. At that time, shortly after, we dispatched and advised that there was an actual robbery that did occur from this same suspicious person individual, and who had now run out of the bank. This person was actually seen leaving the bank and walking just a couple businesses down the road to 7-Eleven. Our officers had started to close in to talk with this individual. That's when our plainclothes detectives have actually made contact, identifying who they were, and advising the individual to stop, and that's when the individual had turned and engaged in gunfire with the actual plainclothes detectives. Both of those detectives were shot. They were both transported to the hospital. One, we believe, is just a glancing leg injury. We believe that he's going to be released here shortly if he hasn't already. The other one is still being treated at the hospital with unknown further condition at this time. I have been advised that these multiple gunshot wounds. I just don't have the further details at this current moment.
And we didn't really see him run from the bank or anything like that. We just heard a shot happen right here. And at first we just thought it was like the tire shop, the tire blew up. Then we heard like repeated ones after that. And then right here we saw him kind of like, we saw someone run back here. And then we saw like cops start running after him back that way. And I mean, that's really all we could really see. It was just happened really quick.
Again, at that time we had patrol officers closing in as well. They witnessed the individual who did engage with the detectives run around the 7-Eleven and into the front of the store itself. They followed in and took custody of the individual without incident. Nobody else was hurt, and there was nothing else at that time. We did have information that this individual did leave the bank with an undisclosed money after handing a note to the teller. We did recover an undisclosed money at the scene as well. We did also recover a firearm, a handgun, semi-automatic weapon at the scene as well.